S-T-I-N-A.
Louise, L-U-I-S-E.
Okay.
My legal name is Cassidy, C-A-S-S-A-D-Y.
C-A-S-S-A-D-Y. Okay.
That's it.
Really?
Miss Louise Cassidy.
Now, where did Chrome come from?
Chrome is my maiden name. I was born Chrome.
K-R-O-N-E.
N-E. That's my Facebook name. That's how come I know when people are snitching on me. The police come to me hollering, Missy Crone.
What's your date of birth, Missy? 4/17/78. 4/17/78. What's your social?
4/02/11/8228.
Right now you're living down in Tennis, or Tennis.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Let's see here. Tell me a story about how you met Donald Hagan.
And yes. Okay. So I told you I'm a realist chick, you know. I'm keeping it all the way real.
Go ahead.
Okay. Before I met Donald Hagan, Donald Hagan's girlfriend Lee had started seeing my girlfriend Jessica inside. Somewhere between Metro and BCDC, I'm not sure where. Okay.
Okay. Now you're talking about Leanne Quinn, Gwen.
Started dating my girlfriend Jessica Hearn inside. Okay.
Right, now hang on. Now, I don't mean, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful at all. Just so I can get okay. Yeah. Leanne's bisexual.
Yes.
When you say your girlfriend, are you bisexual also? Or
yes.
You just, okay, so, all right. Yes. So this was a person you were romantically involved in.
Very much so, yes.
Okay, all right. So
not Leanne, I was not.
No. So when you say girlfriend, you don't mean just a friend. You mean this was your actual romantic partner.
Yes, I mean actual romantic
partner. Okay, all right. So, and her name was what?
Jessica Hearn.
Jessica Hearn, all right.
Okay. Jessica Hearn gets out before Lee gets out. And I already knew they was together. And Jessica needs money to get Lee out. And she needs a car to take down there to get her out. And she needs all this. And I'm just the foolish girl that gave her what she needed, the money and the truck to go get her girlfriend out. Like, I was a little bit, that's the size of one.
Did you know that they were seeing each other?
I did. But I also know Jessica, and Jessica's not all the way there.
Okay.
So, I mean, Jessica, it's just a situation you have to handle right inside the type of way. I knew that this girl was going to chew her up and spit her out, so I was giving her whatever she wanted to help her out.
All right, hang on a minute. When you say chew her up and spit her out, what do you mean?
Okay. I don't know Leanne personally. I did do time with her. I didn't do 30 days with her down here. She was the Fruit Loop. I didn't even get to know her at all. But she knew who I was, what I wanted. Jessica's a certain type of person. She gives too much of herself to people. People like Leanne, people like me. Like, she knew that Jessica was willing to do whatever it took to be with her. And I knew Jessica like that before, too. When my husband left, and I didn't have, you know, I knew Jessica had my back, regardless. And Leanne knew this as well. Leanne used Jessica to get out. Jessica had her surety bond signed here. I could be wrong, it might be vice versa. She used Jessica to have her surety bond signed either here or LMDC, and then get the $500 bond, whatever that was left, at whichever facility, to get out. And I gave Jessica the money that she needed, and I gave Jessica my truck. And I said, I gave it 2 weeks.
How much did you give her?
I gave her a $300-something. She needed $500. I gave her $300-something and my blazer. At the time, I had a blazer. So I gave her that, and they went.
You said you were going to give it 2 weeks.
I gave it 2 weeks, and she's going to leave you. She's going to be right back to her man, Donald.
Okay.
That very same night, Leanne left Jessica sitting at the hotel at Lowell Manor.
Lowell Manor.
That same night, when I said I gave it 2 weeks, she left her the same night
one,
and went back home to Donald, okay?
Okay.
So, anyways.
When was that, do you think?
I was living in Iraq. They had just got out. She had an HIV. I can't really say. I know I was living in Radcliffe in 2014. Not really sure. I know that it was warm outside.
But it was in 2014?
I think so. I can't be 100%.
That's okay. All right.
So anyways, long story short, I was trying to help Jessica any way that I could, because I knew she was on a little bit of her face. I knew what type, I didn't know, but I heard what type of person Leanne was already. And
which was what kind of person?
The type of person that will use you up for whatever she can get to get what she wants.
Okay. Who'd you hear that from?
I couldn't tell you exactly, but it was people that cared about Jessica. They was telling me this was going to happen.
But that was the reputation that Leanne had.
Yes.
Okay.
And so I was looking for I was trying to make some money. And Jessica's like, well, Donald, Leanne's, dude, he can hook you up. So I'm like, okay. So I go over there. I can't believe I'm sitting here telling you about this. So I go over there, and I was like, all right, I need $300. So I gave him $300. I hardly even know this man, but something real recognized as real. Like, you just know. You know what I mean? And I knew he wasn't going to rob me. Everything's going to be fine. He took about $300. I ironically fell asleep on the couch at his house, and because he left to go do whatever he was doing, and he comes up with $280. And he wakes me up, and he's like, Princess, I'm so sorry. I had to use $20 of your money. All I have is $280. I didn't find the person I was looking for to get that for you. And I owe you $20. But here is me and my son's watches. It was father and son watches he had got for his son's graduation. All he owed me was $20. I want you to take these watches until I give you your $20 back. And I said, absolutely not. I'll take that $20 loss. I'm not taking you your son's graduation watches. And he,
All right, square me away real quick before you go on with this story, okay? You went over there and told him, you went over to see Donald because you needed $300?
No.
Because what were you trying to achieve? Just tell me.
I feel like I'm going to burn for this. I was trying to make a purchase from him. I was trying to make a purchase from him.
Okay. Meth or heroin?
Meth. I don't fuck with heroin.
Okay.
I lost my people at heroin. I don't fuck with me.
So
heroin.
$300 worth of meth?
It was going to be A-ball. It was going to be A-ball. Back then,
okay.
It was A-ball.
Okay. All right.
Okay. So he comes back. He don't
so
have
what are you
going
to do with that?
I was going to use it for my own personal use.
So, neither here nor there. So he comes back, he's got $280.
He's got $280, he gives me these watches, and I was like, I'm not doing that, I'm not doing that.
Okay.
I secretly sneaked the watches into the crease of his couch because he wouldn't take them back, and I wasn't going to walk out the door with it. I'm very much about the kids. So anyways, he's like, he calls me up one day, and he's like, I got your $20. I'm like, dude, keep the 20, the watches are in the couch. He found the watches. Okay, that's over with. Then I'm dating at the time. Right, I'm going to say within a week or two, I'm dating John Whitlow, who rents from Terry Walker.
Okay, where does John Whitlow rent? What property?
He was renting, I want to say it was called 8th Street in West Point. It was a yellow building. He lived in the top apartment.
8th Street in what?
I think it's 8th Street in West Point.
8th Street in West Point?
Yeah.
Okay.
W-H-I-T-L-O-W?
W-E-S-T-P-O-I-N-T. W-E-S-T? Mm-hmm. Westlow.
Oh, his name?
Yeah.
It's Whitlow. I'm sorry. W-H-I-T-L-O-W. In West Point.
Right. I'm with it. Right.
Okay, so me and him somehow, I don't even know how I ended up with that cat.
Okay.
Somehow we merged. And we're chilling at the house. He has 5 kids. And we're chilling at his house, and we get the call. Terry shot Donald Hagen at her house. I didn't know what none of that meant. I didn't know who Terry was. I didn't know who Donald Hagen was at the time. I didn't know what that meant. No, yes I did. Yes I did. Yes I did. Yes. I had already met him before and been to his house. So somebody was there that I did not know. I know Jasmine. I know Ian. I know Terry. I just fucked up. I don't remember. Something was happening. Donald Hagen got shot. And
you were at John Whitlow's house when the call came. Who called?
I want to say it was a detective, but it might have been Cynthia. S-E-N-T-A. She does tattoos.
S-E-N-T-A. N-T-A.
She just got married, but her maiden name was Little. L-I-T-T-L-E.
Okay.
She's very easy to find if you search her on Facebook. She's a heavyset blonde.
And she does?
Tattoos. I'm pretty sure she's the one that called her, but like I said, I hate people from someone's shirt and said, did you hear, you know, this and this and that's that. And everything was just so an uproar for that. Like, every community, everything, everybody, everywhere. Okay, so.
And she said that Terry Walker shot?
No. Whoever called said that Donald was at the Pink Liquor Store. They didn't think he was going to live. He got shot at Terry Walker's house. No, he got shot on Terry's property. Okay. That was the words. But they couldn't get the phones to work. That's what it was. Nobody's phones worked up there, so they apparently drove him to the liquor store because the phones didn't work, but we later found out because everybody there had warrants, they didn't give a fuck if Donald Linder died. They didn't want him to die there. Because then people had warrants. I'm not for sure that that's the case. That's what I remember. So, you know, that was a big deal. Everybody was talking about that. I tried my best to stay out of it because I did not know those people well enough, and I had my own shit I was absconding then. I'm really not a flight risk. I'm really just a mom. I just want to be home with my kids.
I'm listening.
I'm trying to think where everything went from there. Erica, John Whitlow's ex, Erica, was flipping out every single day over Donald. This and that was happening. All this shit was happening. But regardless, all I remember is there is nothing nobody could say to convince anybody that Terry didn't do it.
Why?
I didn't know at the time because I didn't know her.
Okay.
Now that I know her, there's really not much of anything I put past her because I know for a fact she broke in my house. And I know that she's into this heavy witchcraft. And she's so, this belt to be exact, because it has my name on it. And she told somebody that she needed something that belonged to me that had my signature, my name, or something else on it. Okay? I know this might sound real fucked up to you, but I'm telling you, this is God's honest truth. I have partial of a video of her trying to make a broom stand up by itself in my living room. She's so, I couldn't figure out if she was high. Because I don't fuck, like I said, I really don't fuck with heroin. I found some heroin in my driveway, so it dropped, and she told me that she'd give me a receipt for double the rent if I got her some heroin. So that one single time, I was going to do it because that's my rent, that's my kids, that's my...
Okay.
Like, she would, there was times and times she would come over just acting weird, like on some spiritual, witchcrafty type stuff. And, I just looked at the video last night when she was trying to say that broom up. Anyways, she had said something to somebody. I'm going to tell you where you're going to get more interest than anybody at, is Brian Wiggs.
Okay. Why Brian?
Wiggs? Brian Wiggs. They are like these anchors. Yes. And they lives on John Adams. They're like peas and carrots. He was her... They were besties when I got the house, okay?
Which was when?
December... I'm going to say 2 weeks maybe before Christmas. No, it was around the 5th. It was around December 5th when I moved in.
2015?
Of last year, yes.
Okay.
Okay. Because a friend of mine, Kristen... Tiller, I'm just giving you details.
Okay.
A friend of mine, Kristen Tiller, had called me. I was living at Little Manor. Everybody's got a story. I'm not going to stand and tell you mine, but it's tough. But I made it, and that's okay. I was living at Little Manor. My friend Chris is like, hey, you still want to work? If you're looking for work, we're going to clean up this house, get it ready. The renters are ready to move in, blah, blah, blah. I go over there to help them get the house ready for these renters. These renters declined, so they didn't want the house. And Terry's like, hey, you want the house? I'm like, fuck yeah, I want the house. I've been homeless for 2.5 years. My husband ran out, my brother died, and life was just bad. So I took the house, and she was willing to take installments, like she was splitting the deposit and stuff. So I took the house. The first night I was in the house, Brian Weeks showed up. He was cool, but he was very, very quiet, sit back, and taking in all the information type guy. And sorry, I'm a little ADD too. So, so catch me if I fall. I could tell that him and Terry had some type of not really a relationship, connection, per se, that me or you would not know anything about. It was just weird. Like, okay. they could, they was in touch. So, I didn't know nothing about the lady other than I knew that she was supposedly responsible for the death of Don Megan. I didn't care about that. I hate to sound like a poor heartless bitch. I was homeless with 3 kids. I didn't give a fuck about none of that. I wanted a home for me and mine. So we took it, and I was warned. I was warned by everybody. Everybody, Missy, this is not going to be good. You're going to hate this. It's going to blow up in your face. But I was desperate, and I didn't want to lose. I didn't want to lose any more than I've already lost. You know what I mean? So I took the house, and the first night we was there, she comes in the next morning, tripping. We're tricking. We are tricking girls out of the house. We are cooking dope. Somebody was outside the window. Mike Vance was outside the window. Seen all this shit happening. I'm broke as hell. I could have cooked dope if my life depended on it.
She was saying this was what
she was doing. Saying this is what happened because Nikki was there. And Nikki was supposed to be her girlfriend at the time. Kristen Tiller, Nikki, same person. And that's when I realized, oh, I'm fucking with something here. Because she kept telling Nikki, I don't give a fuck. I'll call the cops. Say, hold up, we don't call the cops. Unless somebody's laying there dying, not breathing. We don't call the cops. We don't call the cops because somebody, because you heard somebody say they listened to the window. What was it? A cooking dope and chicken hoes with the windows wide open, right? It was just something for her to bitch about, whatever the fuck she had going on there. And that's when I realized, like, this chick can flip the script quick. I mean, everybody went from one level of just coolness and chill to just off the chain up in the air. And I'm just not with that. I like to lay low and be quiet. I don't need no drama and none of that. Even when I'm not wanted, I don't want the attention. I don't need it. I'm a pretty girl. I've got planned that my whole life. I don't need that shit. Some people are different. So she, you know, I realized what she was about, yada yada, whatever, whatever. There's been a lot of fuck shit that has came and went with the rent in the house. Like, per se, right now there's a, what's it called when you own the bank money? No, it's taxes. It's back taxes. She had a letter sent to my house because she didn't want to give her address. I didn't get that. You just was went through this murder thing. Not know where you live, like that didn't make sense to me. Anyways, long story short, I opened her mail and it said that they were going to foreclose on the house within like 17, 18 days. And I'm tripping because I'm paying my rent, I'm not just on time, I'm ahead of time.
Right.
I went without a home for a long time. And she was just like, well, how do you know this and how do you know that? And she's very, as I'm a researcher and I want to do my research before I speak what I got to say, I want to make sure I know what the talking about before I say it. She's the same way Terry Walker is. However, she don't give a fuck if she's right or not. She gonna say whatever she wants to say. As far as the thing goes, okay, so let me go back. The electric was off. Okay, the electric was on at first. 2 days later, the electric's off. I never paid her $1,650 because she said, don't worry about the utilities.
But it was hooked up illegally.
It was hooked up illegally.
Okay.
She didn't tell me that. She made me believe that those, the water and the electric, or the electric and something, was on in her name.
Gas, is it gas in there?
Yes, probably. Okay, so
probably electric.
So she's like, don't worry about the electric. Don't worry about none of that. It's in my name. Just make sure you pay me, and then me and you will work out the rest amongst ourselves. Well, that happens all the time with me and landlords and tenants. Well, I didn't think nothing of it. I didn't know this chick. 2 days later, they come turn the lights off. I'm pissed. I done paid you $1,650 that I did not have, that I went and did following knows like I did to get it.
Well, that's a good question. And I'm not trying to hem you up on anything, but you're telling me that you're paying
was in the catch of my counter section. However, I'm old and fat and tired. So we went back over here to where, like...
No, wait, slow down.
We help people...
You were doing what now? You were working Craigslist doing what?
We were working casual encounters, like guys want a date. Yeah, guys want a date with a pretty girl, or they want body rubs or whatever. All right, so I got all tired and fat for that. So on the other side, at the bottom of Craigslist, people will post things like, little old lady needs help getting their fish tank cleaned out, or the driveway swept, or the yard cut, things like that. So
you're going from doing the escort thing to basically doing like odd job kind of, is that what you're telling
basically,
me?
Yes. Okay. Sometimes that may collide. I mean, I'm not going to lie.
Sometimes that collides, right?
It might coincide. He might want me to clean his house naked. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So we're doing that. And I told Terry, I said, it'd be better if, first of all, I can't pay you what you want me to pay you and get this ledger back on. If she had told me from Jump Street that the ledger was on illegally, I could have figured that out, but she didn't. She had me sneaky about it. So I told her, I said, I can't pay you no more money until I get this ledger sitting on. So the entire month, basically, of January, I did not live there. I stayed at Biff's.
Of this year. Okay.
There may be one or two nights where we got a kerosene heater and went to the house because me and Mo was going to be alone or whatever. But generally...
Who all was living in Biff's? Did you have kids with you then, too?
No.
Well, who all was living there if you wanted to be alone?
It was just me. Well, if I had my kids, I went to... Me and my kids' dad are cool. If I want to be with my kids, I can go there with my kids. I can take them to wherever I be with my
But
kids.
You said you'd take the heater and go to the house if you wanted to be alone. Who else was living in with you at Biff's then?
Nobody. It was just Biff's was... It's a Valley Station. Me and Mom was the only way to know that we was together. He had somebody and I had somebody.
Okay.
All right. And Crystal and Adam Sanders popped up there that night with my belt and it kind of freaked us out a little bit. So we would go back. We went back to the house for whatever reason. Well, I go to pay my rent at the beginning of February and she's like, tell you what, you haven't been in the house all month and you got robbed. I forgot about that part. I come home one day and it's freezing cold in the house. There's no electric. I had on some blue jeans. I had on some brown furry boots up to here. I had on a brown furry jacket and something else. This is my favorite outfit. This is the only reason I remember this. It's my favorite outfit, especially in the wintertime. And I came in the door, and it was freezing cold in the house. And I was like, hurry up. I was telling my mom, hurry up and go in the bedroom and find this and that. And I'm standing in the living room, strip down as fast as I can. I get clothes back on as fast as I can. It's freezing cold in there. And I remembered my belt was in my jeans. My boots were still connected to my jeans because I took it all off at once. It was, you know what I mean? So I take everything off. And my hoodie. I have my favorite hoodie on. Take it off. We get dressed. We swap out clothes. We roll right back out the door. I came home. I'm pretty sure I missed a whole 24-hour period. On the second day when I came home, the back door didn't have it had a lock, but you could pop it so easy with a credit card. I mean, a 2-year-old could have done it. It was so simple. I knew immediately somebody was in the house. When I opened up the door, the kerosene heater is a very distinct odor. You do not... That heater just got turned off. I mean, I wish I told Moses it was a million times. I wish I just walked over for 1 second, put my hand next to it to see how hot it was, but I didn't. I was too worried about looking to see what was missing. I couldn't really tell what was missing because it was stupid stuff missing. Like, I didn't really have nothing worth money at the time. I had just come off the streets. Like, I had me, my kids, my clothes, and that was it. And I've come a long way from that. I've just been in there. I started looking for things that were missing. I just couldn't pinpoint anything that was gone until I went looking for it. There was a friend of mine had left a box with a copier in it, with a fax machine, with something you hook up to your computer. I want to say a copier or fax machine. I didn't see that anywhere. This is the day Jim Church picked us up from Biff's and took us to the house. We got to the house, I realized I did not have my keys. I'm on the phone with my girlfriend, Jessica Hearn, who's in Dismas. And she's like, I didn't know you were from Terry Walker. Because Jesse knows Terry Walker. I don't want you fucking with her. Don't go to that pharmacy, whatever you do. Don't go to that pharmacy, whatever you do. Do not go to that farm. I'm at the house looking to find out what's missing right now, okay? At calling Jessica, and she's like, I don't get, don't go. All of a sudden, I hear a car revving up right here behind me. I'm standing at my front door. I turn around as Terry Walker talking about getting the car. We're going to the farm. I said, I ain't going to the farm with you, Terry.
Why did she show up there? You're at the house.
Because Mumbles.
You're at the house on Tennis.
Yeah.
And June Mumbles.
Yes, and Chuck dropped us out there, and we're trying to go inside the house to get clothes, or it was going to be an accident.
But you realized that you'd gotten robbed at that point.
I had already known I'd been robbed, and I was trying to figure out what else was missing. And we were talking about it all the way over there. I was like, somebody's been in this house. I knew immediately when I pulled up in front of the house. This is the second trip. Immediately, I knew somebody had been at the house. The first trip, after I got robbed, I didn't even know. Because I guess I wasn't looking for what was missing. Okay. And Terry had called me. I'm sorry, my memory is so
sorry, messed take up. Your time.
I'm trying to tell you what I remember.
Take
as
your time.
Soon as I remember, all right. I forget.
Take your time.
Okay, I forgot this part. Terry had called me a day or two before and said, are you at home? And I said, what do you need? Because I've been through it. I've known every type of person there is to know in this world. You don't call me and ask me where I'm at. Or I'm automatically going to be suspicious. You know what I mean? And she's like, are you at home? And I said, what do you need? She said, well, are you at home? And I said, don't matter if I'm at home. What do you need? And, well, I was just calling to find out this and this. And hey, just trying to be my buddy and shit. And I didn't like her. And I didn't want to try to be her buddy. I wanted to be able to be my landlord. I wanted to pay her and get her in my face. And at that time, I hadn't realized I'd been robbed yet. So here we are back at the second trip. Because Terry called me before I made that first trip to the house. I think. She did. She called me. She kept asking oddly where I was at. She needed to go in. She needed to go in the house for some reason. And I said, no, don't go in my house. And she's like, well, you know, I'm the landlord. And I said, then you got to give me 24 hours in advance before you go in my house. She was acting like it was an emergency, like maybe a gas leak, or I just don't want to say it until I know for sure what I'm talking about.
That's okay, but she needed to go in the house.
She needed to go in the house. Okay, so.
So you're outside, you hear a car revving up.
So, yeah, so me and Mumbles are there, Jim charged and left, so we're already like, fuck it, we're walking back to the room to get the keys.
But you said you were on the phone.
I'm on the phone with Jessica, and Jessica's like, I didn't know you were in from Terry Walker. Please, don't go up there, da 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 da. And I heard the car revving up, and I turned around, and it's Terry Walker, and she's like, get in the car, we're going to the farm. And I was like, I'm not going to the farm. And Jessica could hear her, and she's like, just don't get in a car, don't get in a car. And Mumbles is like, she ain't going to the farm unless I'm going to the farm. She said, all right, get Mumbles, no. God, I wish I could remember. Mumbles acted like he was going to hop in the back. He acted like he was, or he said he was. And she's like, no, I want you up front. And I already knew something was fucked up because Terry does like me a lot.
Right.
She does not want no dude in the front seat.
She has a romantic interest in
you. Yes.
Okay.
Especially when she thought that, when she found out that I had the H. She was really like, wanted to take me to a show, but she'd only take me to a show if I promised to have dinner, but she'd only let me have dinner with her if I promised to hold her hand in the show. Yeah. I know that makes sense, but that's how it went.
Okay.
And, so I'm like, we get in the car, and she's like, Mumbles. It's very important for y'all to know that I do not fuck with heroin. I swear to Christ I don't. I found this shit in my driveway, and I just knew she wanted it, and that's where I went with it. Went straight to her. I wanted to get out of my position as soon as possible. Robin Gaines killed my brother on heroin years ago, and I just, so she starts questioning Mumbles about what the fuck. What's up with the H? What happened to the H? He's like, I didn't take shit. Yada yada. Regina took it. Regina da da da. Of course, Regina's been around here. Regina OD'd in the fucking bathroom upstairs at the same hotel we were at. He, I think, went home to his real girlfriend, and I don't know what happened there, but she called the cops on him, and he got arrested too. So they both ended up in jail the next morning from where they left me. So the next day, I found out they're both in jail, and this is this and that's that. But first, the main thing, we were in the car when she said,
where you left off was, she says, get in the car, we're going to the farm.
Yes.
And you said, I'm not going to the farm with you. Yes. And then Mumble said, she's not going to the farm unless I go with you.
Right.
And then she tells him to get up front, which you thought was odd because she liked you.
Immediately, I knew it was odd. Okay. Immediately, I knew something was up.
Okay.
So he goes up at the front, and she, I wish I could remember word for word, but she, there's a look these heroin addicts have. There's a look that you can't, you just know it. It's just pure evil, Satan, and it was all over her face. And I had never seen or heard her act like that. Mind you, I did not know her that long. It might have been 3 months only. But I dealt with this bitch, this army chick, a lot. Because she always had to come over and stop by and say something, always something. And she said, I wish I had pen and paper. She said,
you
I know
paper
for,
right here, you write something down.
Yeah, because I forget so fast.
Sorry.
She said, I know for a fact that you and that girl took that heroin from Misty. And Misty was using that to get to me. So the way I see it, you brought me, is what she told him. And he was like, what the fuck, you know, he's just, you know, what the fuck. And she says, I guess she may have showed him what she had, whatever that was. And he's like, hold up, bitch, don't think I'm no punk, because I will not forget that, because I've always thought Mumbles was a punk. So when he said, hold up, bitch, I ain't no punk, like, you ain't gonna tell me. And she's like, well, let me tell you this. She said something to this effect, I cannot tell you word for word. They've already reopened the case on Donald. I'm already facing life in prison. What's one more gonna hurt? What's one more gonna change anything? Something like that. I wish I could remember more. God, I can't remember more. But she said, she somehow knew this case was reopened. I don't know how or where. I guess it's where she snitched on Crystal and Sherry. Or wherever that, I don't know, however that went. To us, she snitched on them to get them out. That's how we look at it. Because she don't want to write up leases. She don't want to write receipts. There's certain little things that she, her business, just no ethics at all. I don't know, junkies have more business ethics than what she's got. So that's what she said. She said, I wish I could remember everything. God, I wish I could have told you that I seen what she had in her hand, but I didn't. I just seen the exchange. I'm from the back seat.
Okay, so let me, before you get to that point, so.
And that's how
so
said,
she said, I know that they've.
I'm sorry,
this
is off again.
And it's okay. That she opened, that I know they've opened the case or reopened the case on Donald. She said that.
She said that.
And she said, I'm facing life in prison.
She said, it's a good chance I'm facing life. I could get life. Something of that nature. And then, like, What's one more gonna hurt? And that's when I was really start. I mean, I was starting to contemplate right now. Do I need to pull this knife out of my pocket and put it to her throat? Is she gonna kill him? Like, I didn't know, because she was that serious.
So the comment that she made,
and her face, the look.
That comment that she made at that time, then you took that to mean.
100%. I took it for everything it was worth.
Which meant what? What did you think that she meant when she said that?
We already had one man down. We already had one man in the grave. That's the way I looked at it. She was going to kill Mumbles.
Okay. So, but when she said they opened the case on, reopened the case on,
there's
on
a
Donald.
New, there, she said there's a new detective. Something like that.
Okay.
There's a new detective on the case. They reopened the case. It caught us by surprise because, like, we thought we knew everything. We really did. And she said, so I can give you more. She said that. She said the case has already been reopened on Donald. I'm already facing, I don't know how many years, life, whatever she's facing. What's, you know, if I did something, I don't know what she said exactly.
Did you take, because I'm not putting words in your mouth and I don't want to generate thoughts for you.
Definitely.
Did you take her words to mean that she had something
100% yes, I did. And I didn't know her that well. I didn't know him that well. But I know people pretty well. 100%, there's no doubt in my mind.
Okay.
That she was... Okay.
I'll
say there's no doubts, because I have said to people many times before, I feel like she's trying to take street credit for this. I feel like there's been times where I felt like maybe she didn't do this, but she wants people to think she did, like she's trying to get street credit for it. But then I'm a researcher, and I don't know. There's a couple of things about the case that I've heard that I don't know for a fact, but that really make me feel like she did it. And oh my God, I'm getting goosebumps out of my body right now.
Like what?
There's a lot of things, like the trip. I don't know for sure this even happened. This is what I heard. There was a trip to the gun range earlier that day with her and Donald, and maybe somebody else, I don't know. This is what I heard. To me, that sounds like her. That's premeditated to me. That sounds like she took him to the gun range for the sole purpose of both of you are now going to have gunpowder residue all over your hands or your clothes or wherever, however that goes. Like I said, I'm not no expert.
Who told you that?
The gun range thing, I actually just found out not too long ago. I want to say Crystal. Somebody knew this been hanging out. Like, I don't really mess with a lot of people.
Okay.
Somebody knew this been hanging out. I want to say it was Crystal Oliver that said they went to the gun range. But as soon as I heard it, I was like, oh, it's premeditated. I'm pretty smart.
Okay, really? let's roll this back to when you're in the car.
Right.
Okay. So you're in the car, and she says, you think that you recall her saying something to the effect of that the case had been reopened on Donald, and then she was
already facing X amount of time.
Okay.
What's it gonna hurt if I do you into?
And she said, like she said this to Michael Corum, Mumbles.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So she says this to Mumbles, and what's he say?
He was just saying, like, I ain't no punk, bitch. Like, you know, I ain't trying to beat up no woman, I ain't trying to hit no girl, but you can get it. He was letting her know that he's not afraid of her. But I know him well enough, every look on his face, he was scared to death.
Now, where were you guys going?
We were going from the house on Tennis to Bibb's Motel to get my keys, because we had kind of rented from somebody else, but I forgot my keys.
To get your... Oh, so you weren't... Now, let me make sure I got this right. So you got a ride from...
His friend's church.
Okay. Jim Church. You got a ride from Jim Church from Little Biff's Motel to the address on Tennis.
Yes, sir.
But when you got there, you didn't have your keys to get in.
Right, so we're kind of stuck there.
But Church had already, he'd already taken off.
Yes.
So you guys were stuck.
When she pulls in, she didn't even use the driveway. She come through the yard all the way up. I remember being in my house.
Yep, I do.
The sidewalk is covered with that wood.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She pulled up to that wood right there.
Okay.
I'm on the phone with Jessica. Jessica screamed, don't go to the farm, don't go to the farm, don't go to the farm.
Okay.
And Jessica heard say,
So she's, and at that point, when does she realize that, I mean, did you all obviously had a conversation and you told her I don't have my keys?
Yeah.
Okay.
She was just
Did she not have keys to the house?
She did have keys to the house. That's another thing. I'm glad you mentioned that. She said, I got keys to the house up at the farm. And I said, well, I've got keys to the house right here at Bibb's.
Okay.
Oh, well, we're going to the farm to get my keys. Why? Why would we go? Do you know where Bibb's is?
I do.
Okay. Why would we go all the way to the farm to get your keys when my keys are right here? Don't none of that make sense. I'm so glad you used that, because I forgot about that.
Okay, so you guys...
So I convinced her that we're going to the room. I used my kids as leverage. I hate to say it, but I was like, my kids are up there. I don't have time to go all the way to the farm and all this.
Okay.
Crap. Just take me to the room to get my keys.
Okay.
So we went to the room and got my keys.
And that's when all this is happening in the car. Now tell
me.
Yes. Okay. So she's threatening Mumbles in the car.
Yeah.
Okay. Over the heroin.
Yes. Okay. And she's just like I said, I mean, I don't even know what else to say. She was just letting it be known that she is not afraid to use
okay.
the utensil or whatever she's got in her hands.
Did you see the gun? And when she's making these statements to Mumbles, did you see a gun at all?
I cannot sit here and say that I seen the gun. But I seen their hand, their jet, everything. I seen from here back, I seen shit was popping off in the front seat. And I could hear it, and it was obvious as hell. But I can't sit here and tell you, honestly, that I seen it.
Okay, that's all right.
If and I know this will never happen in many years. If somehow he could say, remember this, I might just, might pop off. But I can't say, honestly, right now that I've never seen
so
it.
So what?
I've never hearing it.
Right.
As far as them passing it back and forth and him saying, ha, it's jammed. You know, like, stupid Biz, whatever.
Now, was that before you got to Biff's?
I believe it was on the way to Biff's.
Okay, so you're driving up to Biff's, which is not that far away from your house.
She went the long way up Watson Lane instead of going the short way. She went the long way.
Okay, so she's going the long way. She's threatening him. And then at some point, you said you're seeing activity or whatever, and you heard him say it's jammed. Did you hear?
There's no doubt in my mind that she had a gun in that front seat.
Okay.
I'm not going to sit here and say that I've seen it.
Okay.
I may have seen it and just don't remember.
Okay,
because,
that's fine.
But
I don't want you to try to make up something you don't want. I want what you absolutely remember.
That's right, and I won't do that.
Okay.
But there's not a doubt in my mind that she had a gun.
Okay.
Number one, Mumbles ain't the most trustworthy guy, but I know he was not lying. And I seen the transaction. I seen...
When you say you saw the transaction, what did you see?
I seen... When she's looking at him... Because she's looking at him and she's saying, I'm not afraid, or I'm not scared, I'm already looking at the X amount of time, whatever. You know, it was in her face. Like, she was not scared. She did not have a care. She did not give a fuck about his life at that point. She didn't take it. And I could tell that he grabbed it. He was like, I don't know what this is, or something to that effect.
Did you see him grab something?
He grabbed something, but I can't say
that. But you don't know what?
The gun for sure.
Okay.
But I don't doubt it for one second. I don't know.
And you heard him say what? You saw him make a grabbing motion?
He said, I know this. I know this weapon. I know this pistol. I know this whatever. It's probably jammed, Terry. And he laughed in her face. And he kind of like did whatever he did and handed it back to her. And I was like, what the fuck did you hand it back to her? You know, I'm tripping. And he just looked at
me. But you still hadn't seen a gun at this point.
I didn't see it.
Okay, you just saw what? Just saw hands moving? Just saw arms moving?
I saw the hand movement. I mean, I seen this, because I'm right here. I seen this back and forth. I heard, because I'm a criminal, I know what the gun sounds like when you're handling it, whatever. I heard what sounded like, very much a gun being handled. I seen...
When you say a gun being handled, like what?
Like, you know... When you handle a gun, there's certain things you just hear sounds like a clack. Maybe my ring's hitting the barrel, or my ring's hitting the.
You heard metallic sounds.
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
And
did you hear? I mean, a gun being racked makes a very distinctive sound. You know that. Did you hear a gun racked? Did you hear a magazine drop? Did you hear? You know, or was it just metallic sounds?
Just sounds. Just handling, like they were handling it. Not, well, I didn't hear him get caught. I didn't hear none of that. Matter of fact, when he said, here's a jam, let me fix it for you, I was like, I didn't get that. You know what I mean? I guess I never heard a gun jammed, but I could tell, I know him well enough to know the looks on his face and the words he's using and how he's acting. It was a gun in her. I'm pretty sure
okay, that's okay.
And the look, she was not, I'm telling you, there was something about her at that moment when she looked at him and said, I'm not afraid. I've already lost half my life. It was like, what's this? And, God.
But all this happened before you got to Biff's.
It was so fast. But yes.
What happened when you got to Biff's?
We got to Biff's. I can't find my keys, so I'm searching for my keys. I had 2 duffel bags in my purse. And I was searching madly for the keys. I can't find the keys for shit. But she was pissed. She was pissed off about the heroin thing. She was mad about something else too. I think it was money. And I'm telling her, I'm not paying you nothing. I can't even live down living at Biff's. I did pay her money. Yes, I did. she don't know how to handle her money. I can't pay her the whole rent in the first week. She'd blow every bit of it on dope, and then next week she's here harassing me again. So I'm like, how about this? How about you go write this lease up? You make it to however much I'm going to pay you weekly so you can space your money out right, since you're 50 years old and can't handle that. You tell me what you want me to do, because I was pretty much at her disposal. I wanted a home for my kids, and that's all I cared about. And she made me pay her, I can't believe I'm remembering this, she made me pay her $80 after I'd already paid $40 for my room that day. I was like, I can't believe I'm really doing this. And Mom was like, don't do it. And I'm like, I need this house. I need a fucking home, you know. And, gosh, I can't remember. There's so much more. There is so much more I wish I could remember and tell you.
So you were looking for your keys. You had two duffel bags and
my purse. Okay, so I found the keys in my purse because the inside pocket of my purse was ripped.
Okay.
And I found the keys down, buried in there. I pull them out. I'm like, okay, let's go back to the house. I tell the girls to stay there. Haley and Kinsey was in the room. They're like 19 and 17.
Yeah.
I just, you know, it seems like somebody said or did something to bring an extreme calm to her. I don't know what it was. It had to be dope. But it wasn't H. Something made her feel all the way better after I found the keys. And if I remember, I'll definitely let you know what it was.
Okay.
But she was just, she does that though. She's so bipolar. She flips so fast you can't keep up. And for some reason, I just don't remember her being pissed, or I don't remember any more confrontation or nothing after that. I remember going to the house. Before she showed up, no, because I didn't have the keys then. It must have been a different time. There was a time when we came in the back door and I could smell the kerosene heater. I could smell cigarettes burning. And we're not there for 4 or 5 days at a time. There's no way you still smell this strong. And I said, Mom, somebody just left here. Like, as soon as we put in this driveway, somebody was in here. Because when you look at my house, the driveway goes straight up to the extra room that's built on the end. Used to be the back porch. Somebody was sitting up against that wall. The ashtray right here. Oh, God. Somebody was in the house right before we pulled in. And they was like hurrying up and turning shit off. Okay. That night, after this shit goes down with Terry, and she's starting to shoot mumbles, that night, Adam Sanders shows up beating on my door.
Who does?
Adam Sanders. They call him Batman.
Okay.
He's incarcerated right now.
Okay.
He shows up at the door, and he has my belt. He's got it all the way rolled up in his hand. And me and Adam aren't real close no more because he's made some decisions that I'm just not, and that's besides the point. But he was in my wedding. We're that close, okay? He unrolls the belt and shows it to me. And this is like out of two husbands and 4 kids, I still got this belt. You know what I mean? And it was very important to me, and he unrolled it, and he showed it to me, and I was like, where'd you get this? He said, I can't tell you. And he was driving a truck, and there was a girl in the truck on the passenger side. And I seen her, but I didn't see her, but I could tell there was a person there. And I said, the back of that truck, give me this. He said, let me tell you this. Terry Walker broke into somebody's house, brought all her shit in there with her. Mike and Nikki brought her to Crystal's house. She had my jeans with the belt still in them. She had the boots with the fur. Nikki brought me the boots with the fur back. Crystal Oliver was making a statement by doing this. She did not know me. She'd never met me. I don't even know if she never even heard of me. But I think she was that close to Adam, Batman, Sanders. She knew that he knew who Misty was. And she wanted to let me know that she wanted to let me know what was happening with Terry Walker.
Crystal Oliver wanted you to know
that
Terry Walker had broken into your house. Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Yes, because I'm quick to blame.
How do you know Crystal Oliver?
Through this. This is how I met her. When Adam brought me that belt so I can't tell you. But she said that she knew this belt belonged to somebody because my name is branded on the back of it.
So did Adam know?
Adam knew it immediately.
He knew whose belt it was.
Crystal said, I know your belt. I don't know what happened. Crystal brought it to his attention. He's like, oh, yeah, that's Missy's belt. Like, that's
okay.
My best friend's wife.
Okay.
Belt. It brought it to me. And that's when I realized, this bitch is, and I think I...
Now, where did the belt come from?
I got it at the flea market.
No. Oh. No, that's not what I mean. I mean, where did Crystal and Adam get the belt?
Trey Walker brought it in to Crystal's apartment in West Point with a box full of stuff. She said, including the copier thing that was missing. It wasn't mine, it was somebody else's, but it was missing. The boots, Terry didn't bring them back to me personally. And this is how criminally how she thinks. She didn't bring them back to me herself. She made Nikki bring them back. Nikki didn't want to bring the boots back. Nikki wanted to keep the boots for herself. But Terry's like, no, you're taking them back to cover her own ass.
Why? I don't understand how that would.
I think that she already knew that I had not met Crystal. I hadn't talked to Crystal.
Okay.
They did everything in their power to keep me and Crystal from ever meeting each other. Because we're all the same people. We never met each other. They did everything they could to keep us from each other. I don't know why. But that's how I met Crystal. Now, the first time I met her face to face, I was trying to get my hair braided because I thought I was going to go to jail. I didn't want to get lice. And somebody told me Crystal could braid hair, so she came over to my house, and that's how that started. But the first time that I knew about her was when the belt got brought to me.
Okay. So, I guess the thing that I want to know is that after you guys go to, and we're going to roll it back to, you go to Biff's to get your keys, you find your keys, then all of a sudden Terry's like, just something happened and just calmed her down.
She's just immediately.
Okay, so she just, like, somebody flipped a switch and she's cool now.
Somebody found some dope or something.
Okay, so then you all get in the car and do what?
I'm pretty sure. I don't even think her and Mumbles got out of the car. I think I got out of the car, ran in to grab the keys.
Okay.
I think. And then, yeah, it was a quick in and out because I was already... I was like, you can stay right here, I'll be right back. I'm pretty sure that's how that happened. And we just went straight back to the house. By the time we got back to the house, me and Mumbles were trying to stay there for the night. The teenager was at the room. And I remember trying to light the heater. You had to manually light the heater.
What's Terry do?
She was just different. Like, she was, everything was cool.
Did she just hang out?
She was just chilling, talking to us. Like, she was our best friend. Like, nothing that just happened ever happened. That's how she is. That's just her mentality. It's creepy, scary, and stuff. I don't know, but
so let me revisit this thing. I'm gonna tell the story again, and you correct me if I'm wrong. So, and let's go back and talk about this, because my understanding is at some point you were at a hotel with Mumbles and some girl named Gina in Indiana. Is
yes.
that right? You were at what hotel?
Clarion.
Okay, so you were at the Clarion. When was that?
Just a few days before Christmas.
Okay, so a few days before Christmas, you're
very close.
Okay, so you're a few days before Christmas, you're at the Clarion. Okay. Where did this heroin that you were supposed to get for Terry Walker come into play? Where did that?
Okay, so I was leaving. And there was a baggie on the ground, and I picked it up. And it was nothing I'd ever seen before. And I'm being honest with you, it was nothing I'd ever seen. So I was like, what the fuck? Well, I didn't say nothing to nobody because I didn't know. I might be sitting on $1,000 and somebody might be taking it. So I didn't say nothing until we got to where we was going. Who was I with? It was just me, Gina, and the driver, the guy. I don't remember. The guy worked maintenance at Clarion, and he just wanted some hot girls and blah, 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 and a free room and yada, yada. That guy picked me up first. We went to where Gina was staying, right there where Air Corps Projects used to be, on the corner of that road and the Key Market, and there's a big house right there, but it's actually apartments, but it looks like a big old house. That's where Gina was at. When I was coming out, baby on the ground, and I scooped it up. But I didn't want to say it to nobody. When I got to where I was going, I was like, girl, what the fuck is this? I got there, it's heroin. I was like, oh. I don't, you know, and she's like, that's a lot of it. She's like, you could really, like, make some money off that. And I was like, hmm. But I was scared to death of the stuff at the time, so I really didn't try too hard to do anything, and just so happens, Terry called me. I know you've got this, but you got that. And I was like, oh.
So Terry called you looking for what?
Marijuana.
Oh, marijuana.
Looking for some weed.
Okay, so she was looking for some weed.
Yeah.
And then...
And she's like, I know you got the weed, but can you get any of this? And I was like, I can't get any. But the girl that I'm with, I made it... The girl that I'm with, I know has some in her pocket. How much do you need?
So you made it sound like Gina had some.
Yeah. And
heroin.
Yes.
Okay.
And she's like, well, see if you can purchase that from her, and then I'll purchase that from you, and we'll just take it from there. Well, she's talking like... really taking good care of me on this. And I was like, hell yeah.
Let me ask you.
But I didn't want to.
Let me ask you a question. Now, you said that you're, when you and I talk about you coming here, you said that you were the most real person that I meet.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Let me ask you a question. Are you telling me the truth about finding the heroin on the ground? Now, let me tell you why I'm asking that question. Okay? Because Mumble says that he gave you money to buy the heroin with.
Oh, no.
For Terry Walker.
Not even, no, that's a lie. I wouldn't go out searching for it. I would not make that type of purchase.
Okay. Why?
I just wouldn't.
Why?
I hate heroin. I feel like this would kill my brother, and I watch it kill everybody all around me all the time.
What's the difference between heroin and meth?
I guess the fact that I just don't know that many people that have died from meth is like I do heroin.
Okay.
Heroin and pharmaceuticals, I don't know why, per se, but I just can't stand either one of them. It's not that I've never tried them either.
Fair enough.
I don't want to try either. I'm not saying that one addiction is better or different than the other, but I'm just not.
Okay.
I don't know.
So anyway, so you actually found this on the ground. He didn't give you money. You found this on the ground.
He did not give me money for heroin. Okay. I would not. Right. It would not have happened.
That's fine. So, Terry Walker calls, you make it sound like Gina's got this to be able to buy.
Yeah.
Then what happens?
And she's like, okay, well, if you can get that from her, then I'll give you double right now. And let me tell you, I saved these text messages. I wish I could recover the text messages. I saved these messages for a long time because I knew.
So, you're texting this stuff?
She was texting. Yeah, we were texting back and forth, me and Terry was. And, she was saying, if I brought her, because all I knew is it was 2 G's. I don't know I don't know what it's worth. I don't know that much. Also, it was almost 2 G's. So I'm like, this is how much is there, yada, yada, yada. I hate it so bad, I wouldn't even touch it. Gina had it the whole time. I didn't want to touch it, I would look at it. Put it in the drawer, I don't want it on me. And Terry kept saying, well, what about this, what about this? She kept to the point where I threw my phone off. She was fucking gone. That's the heroin is just ridiculous. And she's like, we was waiting for Terry to get a ride. That's what it was. Terry was trying to get a ride over there because we were kind of far. And as soon as Terry said she had a ride and she was on her way, like I said, I don't touch the fucking heroin. I hate it. They had possession of that. I think, I'm not for sure, when I got in the shower, I believe that they formulated a plan because they both sometimes do heroin. I'm not gonna say either one of our
Mumbles and Gina.
Yes, they both do sometimes like to play or whatever with heroin. I believe that while I was in the shower, they developed a plan. This is what we're gonna do, this is how we're gonna do it, yada, yada, yada. By the time I got out of the shower, I had on a towel and a robe, and within minutes, they were both gone. Within minutes, and they run off with that shit. And then Terry calls me. I had a video of Gina. Gina High sitting on the floor, and I was clowning her. So how does it feel? Does it feel good? Because you look real stupid right now, you know, like type shit.
Right.
And so the only mic was gone. Gina was still there. And I told Gina, I got company coming, you're going to have to get out of here. And she just, like, got out of it. Like, she didn't know what I was saying. She didn't speak back. And So I helped her out the door. I somewhere along the way, she grabbed my tablet and took it with her. And next thing I know, she was in jail with my tablet for ODing on heroin in a public bathroom in that same hotel upstairs.
Okay.
And
so at what point does Terry Walker contact you about the heroin and you say, hey, look, it's gone?
Yeah, I was like, oh, it's gone.
But when did that happen? When did she do that same night?
That same night.
Okay.
I said, I'll tell you where it's at. I said, either Mike or Gina's got it, and Gina's right here. And I was on the phone while I was taping Gina, sitting there high as hell on it. And because Terry kept saying, well, you know what I think? I think you did all of this to set... She's so demented. I think you did all this to set me up with the cops to make me look like an addict. And now that I'm ready to come pick it up, you ain't got it no more. And this is all just a ploy. And I was like, I'm not that chick. I'm not going to play those games. Here, let me record this for you. There's your junkie. There's where your dope went. Mumbles is nowhere around. Mumbles knows that I know when he's on heroin. He knows that he's going to be at the door. So he's going to do it. He goes away and does it. And she was just fucking irate. I mean, I've known a lot of junkies. I come from a long line of losers. I'm not going to lie to you. And I'm not one of those losers. But I know what I see. I know I can tell you who's on what anywhere I go. And Gina was high on heroin. And I was like, I know that you stole it from me, and I really wanted to get her ass, but I didn't. That was my rent. That's my rent. You know what I mean?
I understand. Okay.
I feel like I'm getting myself in more trouble than I'm
No, because that's what Terry Walker wanted. She wanted the heroin.
She wanted versus... that more than she wanted the cash.
Okay. All right. So.
But I was not going to, I wouldn't, Mumbles must be mistaken. I'm like, I'm kind of a liar.
Okay.
But no, he never, Mumbles, first of all, and all the months I've known him, I met him in October, I've never known him to have a dollar, much less to give me money to buy dope, okay?
Okay. So. And let me just go back and revisit this thing. So all that happens, and you said that was a few days before Christmas?
I'm almost positive.
Okay. So it was a few days before Christmas, and then at what point, and so you go, so it's a few days before Christmas, why are you at the Clarion instead of
I'm
home?
I'm trying to think. There was no electric.
Oh, okay. So there's no, so at what point did the electricity get turned back on in the house?
I know it was on by New Year's because I was at home New Year's Eve.
Okay.
I was just a couple days maybe before New Year's.
Okay.
So I'm going to say when I first moved in, around the 5th, and I banged my receipt book and gave me better days.
And when you guys went from, but you stayed at Little Biff's because there was no electricity in the house?
We stayed, yes, for the first couple nights, I did.
Okay, so I'm just trying to get a time frame here.
You're fine.
All right. You stayed to Clarion because there was no electricity at the house on Tennis.
Yes.
Then.
And Clarion was free versus Biff's, we had to pay for it.
How was Clarion
because
free?
Because Regina knew some little guy that worked there that was the maintenance guy.
Oh, okay.
So
all right.
We got one of those rooms that kind of like had the junky crap in it. Like they brought all the broken furniture in there and you cleaned up, moved the shit around, you kept the room.
Okay, I'm with you. All right. So at some point though, you go from the Clarion back to Little Biff's, or you go to Little Biff's. When did you?
Biff's has kind of been an on-off thing for me for quite some time. So,
because here's what I'm trying to figure out. Okay. When was it that Terry Walker came and picked you up at the house on Tennis to go get your keys at Biff's? Was the electricity still off in the house?
Yes.
Okay. But the electricity, you said, got turned back on in January.
It had to been on before. No. It got illegally turned back on.
It got illegally turned back on.
I'm pretty sure. It got illegally turned back on. Because the lights was on New Year's Eve. On New Year's Eve, I had a friend over. Mike was out of the picture. We had electricity.
New Year's
on
Eve.
New Year's Eve.
You had electricity in the house on Tennis.
Yes, we had electricity on Christmas. I know for sure. let's see, books my Facebook right now. I can tell you the dates of everything.
That's all
right. The lights was off and on, off and on. One time it was made to look like the lights was turned on illegally. It was made to look like they were on legally because they were turned on while I was not home. So I come home thinking, yay, you know what I mean? Because we had just been doing LGD, we had to pay this, we had to show a lease, we had to do all this shit. And I thought I was good, but no, I was not good still.
Okay.
They come back and turn it off again.
What I'm trying to figure out is, was it January, February, March? When was it when she picked you up at your house to take you to Biff's?
Okay. I could give you a really accurate answer if I could get, when I get home. Or when
that's
I get
fine.
To my phone.
If you want to text me.
Because I don't want to say, give you the wrong answer.
I understand. Then you text me or call me, just let me know. I just want to get that time frame.
The lights was turned off and on 2 or 3 times.
Okay. So then, but I want to, I just want to get, so that I can understand, and I know we've talked about it 2 or 3 times. I just, one more time, we'll go over it, okay? And you correct me if I'm wrong. So, you and Mumbles are at Little Biff's, and Jim Church comes and picks you guys up and drives you. Do you remember what day it was? Was it daylight?
It was daylight.
Dark?
It was daylight.
It was daylight.
It was so daylight even when we got back.
Morning, afternoon, evening?
It's going to be, I'm going to say, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m.
Okay,
area.
All right, so it's in the evening hours. He comes and picks you up. Jim Church picks you and Mumbles up at Little Biff's.
Yes.
Drives you to the house on Tennis, drops you off.
Yes.
He takes off. Church does. Yes. Church takes off. You guys suddenly realize, oh, crap, I don't have no keys.
Right.
Okay. At that point, you're on the phone talking to
Jessica Hearn.
And next thing you know, suddenly out of nowhere, there's Terry Walker. What's she driving?
It's like Beetlejuice. You said her name 3 times. She was driving her daddy's car.
Which is what?
I believe it's a Ford Focus.
What color is it?
Silver or gray.
Okay, it's like a silver or gray Ford Focus. There she is. And she's like, come on with me. We're going to the farm.
Yes. She was demanding me.
Why did she want to go to the farm? You didn't know? She just said, come
on, we're
going to the farm.
I don't know, but I find it real peculiar.
Okay.
Jesse just said, don't go to that farm.
And you said, I'm not going to the farm. But then Mumble says,
he's trying to play me so tough, guy. Now fuck it, let's get the car.
Okay, so, but he doesn't even know why she's wanting to go to the farm.
No, but he's like, fuck, let's get the car. And I was like, okay. And then you can tell by her demeanor.
No, wait a minute. Now, let me ask you this question. And I'm not trying to, like, give you a story. I'm just trying to understand.
Okay.
Was it the keys? Is that my understanding? Did she want to go to the farm to get the keys, or was it? Did she just say?
Before she knew that we didn't have the keys, she was saying, "Get in the car.
Get in the car.
We're
on the farm." Okay. So and then he's being a tough guy. He says, "You know, she ain't going unless I go."
Yeah, and we're let's go. He's like, "Fuck it, get in the car, let's go."
All right, and she demands that he set up front.
Yes.
Okay. So, and then you guys get in the car. She backs down out of the yard. Essentially,
yeah.
Right? Because you
yeah.
said she's up in the yard.
Yeah.
So she backs up out of the yard, and then you guys are going to Biff's, right?
Okay.
Is it?
Yes. She went the long way. I can understand why she was going that way, because she was going the opposite direction.
So she's taking you guys to Biff's, and then that's when she has this exchange with Mumbles.
So fast, but yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And basically, she shows that when he says I'm not a punk, is that before or after?
She'd already shown him
something. You assume it's a gun, but you don't know.
I don't know for a fact. I did not
but
know
you,
for a fact.
But it, whatever it was that she did caused him to say, I'm not a punk.
Yes.
Okay. And at what point did she say the part about a case being reopened, etc.?
I'm saying almost immediately.
So did he say, I'm not a punk, and then she say,
no,
you know, I don't,
there was,
or did
there
she
was,
say
there
that
two,
first?
There was two type of arguments. The first argument was, she thought that she was going to intimidate him she was, that's how she is. As soon as he stepped in the car, acting like he ain't, even if he was scared to death, acting like he's not scared, she was letting him know right now, leaning over like this, I don't know what this hand is doing, I don't know what this hand is doing. Mm-hmm. But she's like, you think I'm fucking scared? Like, I've already got this case reopened on Donald right now. What the fuck is one more of y'all gonna, what's that gonna do? What's that gonna hurt me? That, I wish I could give you word for word, but I'm telling you this is close. She said that. That's what she said. And he's looking at whatever it is that she's got. And then he kind of smirks and like laughs at her, jerks, takes it from her. And was like, here, it was jammed. I don't know, so bitch or what, he just, whatever he said.
So the words she used basically inferred that she was responsible for Donald Hagen's death, and that she was going to shoot
him. The moment that we stepped out of her car, I looked at Moments and I said, that bitch just confessed to killing Donald. He said, I don't remember what he said, but look. Yeah. I mean, I don't remember exactly what he said, but I just remember that feeling that I had. Like, she just confessed to killing Donald. Like, so fucked up. And he agreed. He, I don't remember exactly what he said, but I was like, I think that was confession. And he was like, that was confession. Like,
well, now you've been renting from Terry ever since, right?
Since December.
Okay, since December. So you've been renting, and then you said you were ahead on your rent. How far?
I've got about half of next month paid.
Okay.
I give her, but it's supposed to be $168 a week. But if I've got, you know, whatever, my daddy sends me money. If he sends me $200, I give her $200.
Okay.
My papa just passed away. We've been getting money that way too.
Okay.
If I've got extra to pay her, I definitely pay her first because, like I said, I've been a long time without a home. I lost my kids and everything over it.
Right.
I'm not going out like that again. So, yeah, I think I'm right about, I think I'm at $200 of June.
Okay.
Which would be about a week and a half.
Is there anything else that you can think of that would be important for me to know?
There is so much more, but my memory is
like,
so fucked up.
Like what? What do you think? So much more?
I mean, I can't tell you, but I know I can tell you this much. I remember writing things down. I remember saving text messages. I remember things that she would say that just didn't sit right with me. I shouldn't even be mentioning it because I don't have proof of it, I know. But there's so much that she has said and done, and she's one of these people that, you know, you know what type of drug addicts there are. There's drug addicts out there that have control of theirs, and there's drug addicts that don't. She's one that don't. And her mouth gets her in a lot of fucking trouble. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go through my Facebook.
Okay.
And I'm pretty sure my psycho ex, Jessica Hearn, knows how to pull up deleted messages.
Okay.
There are some things. I wish I could remember exactly what I feel like an idiot right now, but I know there was things that needed to be brought to someone's attention, per se, that I saved on my phone that just disappeared.
Okay.
Well, what could it disappear? I don't even know. Well, maybe because Taylor Walker's got a key to your house and you sleep like a log because you're always drunk. You know what I mean?
All right, so you got my number.
Yes.
You know that you can call me and, you know, or text me or whatever.
And I also gave your number to my daughters.
Okay.
Because they were tripping.
That's fine.
So I was
like,
this is the number, da da da. They know how to keep their mouth shut. They know.
All right, now here's the thing. You, like I said, you get that information. Anything else pops up, you can contact me, let me know.
Yeah.
You know what's going on.
Is there any chance of her walking out of those doors? Because that's what I'm worried about.
I don't think so.
I feel like I'm sitting in her house, regardless of the lease, regardless that I'm paying, it's her house. You know what I mean? And the other thing I worry about is this. You know, I'm, like I said, I was a foster kid. I've dealt with a lot. There's not a single type of human being I've never met. I was an escort for 5 years, and most of my clientele was cops. You know what I mean? I mean clientele, not like snitches cops, like cops. So there's a lot of upset people in this world. But I'm scared to death that I'm going to say or do the wrong thing and get somebody in trouble for something they may not have done. Should I be saying this?
Sure.
I don't want to sit here and tell you Ted Walker or whomever is guilty of whatever unless I'm 100%.
And here's the thing, I don't want you to sit here and speculate. I don't want you to say, just like the gun thing. If you didn't see it, you didn't see it, and that's fine.
I wish I did. I know, but
what I want is what you actually saw and what you actually heard. That's all I want. I don't want you to make anything up. Right. I would never ask you to do that, okay? But here's the thing. The thing is that whatever you do truly remember, you know, and even that, if just like we had the conversation about the things that she said in the car.
Yes.
I mean, you can recall the things that she said in the car.
Yeah.
You know, it might not be like word for word, but you do know for a fact beyond a shadow of a doubt that she said Donald's name, that she said they reopened the case on Donald. She definitely said that.
Yes, sir. She definitely said that.
Okay, and then she also said something to the effect of, I'm looking at life, or I'm going to get some time.
Nothing to lose is basically exactly what she said.
Okay.
She was not afraid. She was letting him know she was scared.
And then she said to Mumbles, what's one more going to hurt me, or something to that effect. What did she say?
She says almost to the, for the very, I mean, almost to the word, she said that.
Okay.
It's like as if it's, I'm not, you know, if I'm already doing life, you know, I'm not going to say she used the word kill or shoot, but I can take you out right now and it ain't going to matter to me anymore.
Okay.
But she, yeah. Right. It was hard for me not to come to somebody at that battle.
I already
had legal matters.
I understand. Let me ask this question. I ask this question a lot. A couple of people have asked this question too. You said something about Donald that kind of struck me as interesting. You said that you went to Donald and, you know, you told him that, you know, you had $300 and you were looking to, you know, make a purchase from him. Mm-hmm. And he comes back and he had spent $20 in money and he was trying to give you something that was probably worth a lot more than
$20.
Okay. That says a lot about his character. Wouldn't you think so? Every person that I've talked to talks about how that new Donald talks about what a great guy Donald Hagen was, what a super guy he was. Did he have his problems and was he dealing dope and that kind of thing? Yeah, of course he was.
Yes,
but the thing is that for the most part, though, everybody who came into contact with him says that he would have gave you the shirt off his back, that he had your back, that if he knew you, he'd take care of you, you know, that kind of thing. That's the kind of person that I hear.
Yeah.
I never met him. I don't know anything about him. But I'm saying that, you know, that's the kind of person that they say Donald Hagen was, okay? I ask this question every time when I talk to people that knew Donald Hagen. Donald Hagen was such a fantastic guy. Why in the hell won't people stand up and talk about what happened to him?
Nobody wants to be a snitch.
Nobody wants to be a snitch. Why do I have to chase everybody down
to
the village?
I'm already going through it. And they're already on me.
Who's on you?
There were people in that car when y'all put up behind that car.
Okay.
They can't wait to go run and tell it all. I can't tell you exactly individual who is who or what's what, but I do have an ex that contacted me and he's like, you know, you're fucked, right? And I was like, are you threatening me? He's like, no, baby, I'm not threatening you. I'm just letting you know. You live in the village. The police put, you know, and da-da-da. And I'm like, you're marked. And he's like, I'm not saying that. I'm going to do anything to you and I'll help you the way I can. He's like, but just watch your back and please be careful. Please be safe. Please keep the girls in the house. Yada, yada, yada. Apparently, there's a lot more going on out there than I know of, but like I said, I'm just going to stay in my fucking house. I hardly ever walk out my door. If I do, it's go get my kids dinner or to go get toilet paper or some shit like that. chick knew that I'm talking to you. She knew what time I was coming to talk to you. Maybe she don't, but it seemed like that. Maybe I'm paranoid because I'm a little freaked out.
Well, you know, a lot of people act like they know things that they don't know to get you to say things that...
Well, I told her, I said, do not contact me again. I do not know you. I've never met her face to face. I've heard a lot about her. I have no desire to...
Is she associated with Terry Walker in any way?
I don't know that she is, but I know that she's associated with my ex, Jess, who's actually at my house, because I didn't know if I was going to walk out of here or not. I mean, you don't ever know. So I made sure Jess was there with the kids just in case. Yeah, they're grown, but still. Anyways, Jenny keeps on contacting me saying, tell Jess to call me. I said, I don't know who you are. Don't hit me back up again. And she is, I'm Big Titty Jenny. Well, I'm Big Titty Misty. How do you like that? I mean, what's, you know what I mean? Don't contact me again, because I know where this goes. She's one of those names in the village that she's the town squaller type shit. And I just ain't got time for none of that, you know. I am what I am. I am who I am. But I've come a long way. I'm not gonna say I'm perfect at all, but I'm doing pretty good, and I don't want to get caught up in none of this for one. But that whole outside world, I'm okay with sitting in my house cooking and cleaning and making brownies and messing with the kids all day.
Okay.
I'm not getting ready to. I can't do that drama. I was in a marriage for 7 years where it was fine to stop bullshit. I just can't do it no more.
Right.
My whole absconding thing, I'll be honest with you. When they caught me absconding, I was at Jamie White's house over behind Myron Valley Station. I'm pretty sure they snitched on me. That's besides the point. He blew my truck up. I lost my job. He had my phone stolen. All this, I can blame it on everybody. It's my own fault. I shouldn't do it. I was supposed to be doing it. But, I couldn't get to where I needed to be. I was staying on Blue Lake with my kids because my PO felt like that was best. If I'm with the kids and the baby father, maybe I can get some discipline and stay right. The only way to get to Preston was to walk all the way down Blue Lake, and I was running late 2 or 3 times. He wanted me to keep a full-time job, go to JDAC 8 days a week, which means one day I'd have to go twice, because I kept on falling off with alcoholism. And I just was like, I just need to take care of my kids, and I can't do nothing else. So dad's an addict, way beyond I could ever imagine.
Okay.
And so I was like, this is what I'm going to do. This is my plan. My plan was get a place, get my kids back in order, hire me a attorney, and turn myself in.
And that's...
That's my plan. That's my plan.
And that's how you landed where you're at on tennis. Is that...
It was my opportunity knock that I had to jump on it, you know. Even though everybody warned me, this is not where Terry Walker's not. This is not where you want to be. And I was like, but she's so nice. And I was really naive and ignorant. But I'm gonna fix that too. I'm tired, like I said. Y'all are gonna do whatever y'all want to do with me. That for some reason I do trust you, but. Have faith. You can look at my record. I've told myself before, I just have to do it at the right time. It's not about me, it's about the kids. Because their dad is an addict. Before I was an addict, he had never even touched a drug in his life. And I was an addict, and I was like, I'm giving these kids to you because I'm going to lose them. And once they go to the state, it's over. I'd rather their dad have them. He flipped the tables on me. He got an injury, a neck injury, and ended up on my parents. And all downhill. So, yeah, that's the plan.
All right.
I'm going to get everything together, get myself together.
Well, why don't you do this? Why don't you go get your phone, get on Facebook, figure out whatever it is that you think that I need to know in addition to everything that you've told me. I appreciate very much.
I need you to tell me, you want the roundabout date, or as close as I get to the date of the car ride?
Yes.
Okay. What else? I think there was two things that was kind of vital. I don't remember.
No, I mean that's the